Hi guys, this is Rob
and Terry
with Gold Plating Services, and we're making another video for you today. This one is how to do rhodium plating with the Jewel Master, which is the option 3 kit. Comes with everything you need to do gold plating and also rhodium plating, which the extra thing that it includes is this platinized titanium anode and the rhodium plating solution. So we have these gold-plated items here, and it's kind of an industry standard with rhodium to either have them gold-plated or nickel-plated before doing the rhodium plating. The rhodium solution is pretty acidic, so if you put an item in there that's not gold or nickel-plated, it will corrode it really quickly if there's no current. So we're just going to get right into it. The first thing we got here is electrocleaner. These were freshly gold-plated items, and so they don't have any fingerprints. They're already really clean, so we're not going to need to spend much time here. We did have it set at 8 volts, so you know it dropped down to about 7. 7's usually good for electrocleaning. Now we're going to go into the surface activator. Now you may notice it's yellow. That's because after you use it a time or two, it changes from that pink color to yellow. That's just normal and okay, not a problem. Did that only for a couple seconds as well because it's gold. Gold does not require any activation actually, but we do it just for good measure. Double rinse. Now we're ready to go into the rhodium. What voltage are we going to use for the rhodium, Terry?
I'm going to start out with an initial voltage of probably 5.5 or thereabouts, and we'll drop it in. And then we'll turn it until we go up to about 4 volts. The label says 3 to 4, but we're going to do it at 4 just simply because the parts are hanging on the rack, and so we want to have a little bit higher voltage to make sure that the parts are getting the current they need.
So if they're clipped, they have a little bit better connection. And this is just such a fine point of contact that we want to make sure there's enough voltage, basically. And look at how much amperage it's pulling, 7.5 amps.
On these small pieces, and so
it's a power-hungry solution.
Now, the label also indicates 30 to 60 seconds, but we would recommend plating more like in the range of 1 to 2 minutes. And so I think we're going to plate these for probably a couple of minutes.
Well, look how much gassing there is now. The solution's, you can't even see through it. Okay, so we're just going to leave this going here. Okay. The rhodium is a room temperature rhodium, which our rhodium is. Most are not. And that's actually pretty convenient because it's just ready to go. You don't have to wait for it to heat up. You don't have to do anything to it. You just set up and get going. Quite easy to use.
A lot of people don't know what rhodium is, but when you go to the mall and look in the jewelry stores at the engagement rings, and they call it white gold, what you're really looking at is a rhodium plate in almost every case. And it's very brilliant. It's about as white as silver. It's about as hard as chrome. And so it's perfect for jewelry because it will never corrode. Rhodium is one of the most corrosive-resistant materials that you can electroplate with, which can be a problem if you don't get it right. There's no chemically stripping it off, and it's hard, and so it's very difficult to polish off. And so we try to encourage people that are going to use a rhodium plate, make sure you practice and you know what you're doing, and you get the parts thoroughly clean so that you don't end up with a problem. We're going to go ahead and pull them out. It's been a good couple of minutes.
Well, let's check them out.
Let me get the quick rinse here.
Make sure they got covered everywhere.
It's about almost as white as silver. And
all right, if you think they're good, let's pull them down here so we can see them a little better.
Yeah, let's take them off the. These are just little jewelry pendants we had.
So how long could you plate them, like theoretically, you think, before it start to look ugly?
Well, I plated stuff for using this very solution for 3 or 4 minutes, and it really didn't affect the brightness. If you plate too long, then you the brightness goes away and it kind of turns into, instead of it being a brilliant white, sort of a battleship gray. If you, in fact, I've done technical plating for rhodium where we plated 2 microns, we plated it for more than an hour, and it turns gray.
Really? Okay. Yeah. So for practical purposes, you'd probably only need just a couple minutes.
I say 2 minutes is fine. It's going to give you a really good...
That really did brighten that up. That little ball was even...
How about these flat parts? They were pretty nice and bright.
Yeah, I mean, everything looks really good. And there it is next to the gold stuff.
The rhodium this rhodium solution is really easy and it's forgiving, but you just want to make sure that the part is either, if it's freshly gold plated, then you're not going to have to worry about it being clean.
All right, well, there it is, folks. Looks similar to silver, but you don't get the corrosion, and it's really quite simple to use with the Jewel Master. So if you don't have a Jewel Master, the option 3 would be the one to get, because it comes with everything you need to do the gold plating and everything you need to do the rhodium plating. The option 2 comes with just the gold package. If you already have a Jewel Master, then all you need to get is that platinized titanium anode there and the rhodium plating solution, and you'll be ready to go. If you have any questions, let us know. You can either give us a call or email, and thanks for watching.